So you've probably never seen a steam engine like this one before. I'm Darren, and this is the Industrial Revolution. This is what's called a cycloidal steam engine, and it came about as a result of a patent expiration. In 1800, James Watt's patents on steam engines finally expired. That led to an explosion of new designs and pent-up creativity that people have been thinking about, toying about, and experimenting with, but hadn't really been able to put into use until now. It also, as it happens, led to a lot of actual explosions because it also finally opened up the ability to use something called strong steam. Prior to that, steam engines had generally used about 5 psi of steam. The Newcomen engines, Watt engines, use 5 psi and then create a vacuum to actually help with the power stroke. So they were using atmospheric pressure. Once strong steam was unlocked, which was defined at the time as anything above one atmosphere of pressure, about 15 psi, you were able to stop using the condensers to help with your power stroke and just use higher pressure steam, which led to the ridiculously high pressures of 25, even up to 50 psi of steam pressure. Yes, that's right, about the same tire pressure that you use in your car today. So not a lot is actually known for sure about this engine. It was probably built by Bradley's foundry in Stourbridge, England, based on a Fenton, Murray, and Wood design. Has a 9-inch bore, a 24-inch stroke, and only produces about 4 horsepower at 40 RPM. The main factor, and the reason it's called a planetary system, is this system up here at the top. You can see the piston down here, the cylinder, runs straight up and down and goes to the side of that small gear on the inside. That gear rotates around, and as the piston moves up and down, the gear turns, connected to a crank on the back side of it, which turns the central shaft. This actually creates a situation where your shaft turns twice for every full cycle of the steam piston. You get one full rotation as you go up, and you get one full rotation as you come back down. That will double the speed of your rotation, but it does cut your power in half.
Well, that's an interesting design for a steam engine. They never really worked out. And that's probably why you've never actually ever seen one before. They were experimented with, they were toyed with, they were used to play with, but they probably never went into production. The format of this one being much more vertically oriented and very compact in size leads me to believe this may have been designed as a marine engine to drive steamships rather than, say, a factory engine. But unfortunately, we don't really have much information on it. The library here at the Henry Ford Museum, which is a great library, unfortunately closed with COVID, and as of the day I'm filming this, has yet to actually reopen to the public, so I can't get any additional information here, and online searching has turned up absolutely nothing.
But all we know about it was purchased by the Henry Ford here in 1932 and moved to the museum, where it's on display, sort of in a back corner with a couple of other engines that nobody's really sure exactly what all the details are. But even though if we don't know the details, we do still know this is the Industrial Revolution. Before you go, I do need your help. There's two things you can do. Number one is help YouTube get more people to the channel. Easiest way you can do that, completely free, hit like on the video, subscribe to the channel, and best of all, if you can comment more than just 2 or 3 words. That tells YouTube, you know, this video is good, the channel's good, send more people here. Second thing you can do, each of these videos ends up being pretty expensive to actually produce. Obviously it's hours of work for each one, but I also have to actually drive to the locations. And if it's far enough away, I have to spend a night. in order to do all the on-location filming that I do for these videos, that I think is essential for the videos. If you can help out financially, either with a super thanks, or if you can help out over at patreon.com/industrialrevolution, that'll help me to extend my range even further, get out to more and better sites, and bring you even better videos. Thanks for watching. Look forward to seeing you next time.